President Rodrigo Duterte wants his government to shoulder the COVID-19 vaccination of every Filipino. In a recorded message Wednesday, October 14, Duterte says he already has the money for the vaccine.
I have the money already for the vaccine. But hahanap ako ng maraming pera because you know there are now 130 million Filipinos. And to me, ideally, all should have the vaccine without exception. Lahat.
This despite saying earlier, wealthy Filipinos will not get the vaccine from the government because they can buy their own. The president says priority will be given to the poorest Filipino households, soldiers, and police. Finance Secretary Sonny Dominguez targets a 20 billion peso fund for the COVID-19 vaccine. Duterte says he prefers vaccines from China or Russia over those from the U.S. Health Secretary Francisco Duque III is optimistic a vaccine may be available in the Philippines in April 2021. Meantime, the Philippine Red Cross stops conducting its free COVID-19 tests for overseas Filipino workers, medical frontliners, and other Filipinos Thursday, October 15. Red Cross says PhilHealth has an outstanding debt of 930 million pesos. In a statement Wednesday, October 14, Red Cross says it does not have unlimited resources to replenish the testing kits for its laboratories unless PhilHealth settles the debt. Red Cross conducted over 1 million swab tests, representing 21 of the 147 licensed testing hubs in the country. PhilHealth is tasked to cover COVID-19 testing and treatment of all Filipinos. The state health insurer is currently facing corruption allegations after whistleblowers said executives pocketed some 15 billion pesos in funds. The Labor Department says no company or employer will be exempt from giving 13th month pay to employees this December despite financial troubles brought on by the pandemic. Labor Secretary Silvestre Bello III also says on Thursday, October 15, the payment cannot be deferred as the law stipulates workers should be paid their 13th month pay on or before December 31. This despite government's inability to assure access to subsidies for businesses. Bello says the department has asked the finance department for financial assistance to micro and small enterprises. Meantime, Finance Secretary Carlos Dominguez III assures Filipinos the government will not raise taxes anytime soon despite a sharp revenue shortfall during the pandemic. In a Bloomberg interview, he says taxing Filipino citizens when their incomes are down is not a good idea. Tax collections dipped by over 12% as businesses either operated on limited capacity or totally closed as consumer demand weakened. Senator Imee Marcos is under fire for calling the field of study development communication old-fashioned and archaic.
DevCom, even as a subject taught in universities, has been largely debunked. Ano? Hindi na siya uso eh. Wala na ang course yan sa ibang eskwelahan. I really would like to understand the nitty-gritty of this development communication program because it's so old-fashioned. It's sort of cute and archaic.
During the Senate hearing on the proposed budget of the Presidential Communications Operations Office last Tuesday, October 13, Philippine Information Agency Director General Ramon Qualoping tried to explain the agency's DevCom program to Marcos.
Bigger picture, PCO is an end-to-end institution. So PIA is tasked to go down to the barangay level, talk to the individuals. Another is to develop talaga the grassroots customized communication per area.
Triggered by the senator's remarks, the University of the Philippines Los Baños College of Development Communication, where the field of study originated, schools Marcos on DevCom. In a statement Wednesday, October 14, it says driving social change through communication is always at the heart of DevCom. And as long as there are social issues to be addressed, DevCom will remain relevant. The UPLB CDC Student Council meantime says it is politicians like Imee Marcos and her family, especially her corrupt parents, who have made DevCom relevant then and now. Online users also take a swipe at Marcos, whose claim she graduated from the University of the Philippines is in doubt. Rappler's fact check found there are no records of Marcos graduating from UP Diliman. Scientists and students of marine science and geography from the University of the Philippines denounced what they call the below-the-belt rants of Environment Department Undersecretary Benny Antiporda. Antiporda apologizes to the UP community on Thursday, October 15. He says he was carried away by his emotions when he called UP experts paid or bayaran for giving comments about the artificial white sand in Manila Bay. In an interview with ANC Head Start, Antiporda says he just wants to send a message to UP Marine Science Institute that they are partners. The DENR collaborated with the UPMSI on projects as well as co-sponsored a scientific symposium amounting to around 364 million pesos over a span of 10 years. Despite the apology, the Philippine Association of Marine Science says scientists do not deserve Antiporda's malicious accusations, and comments made by experts are constructive and aimed at providing science-based inputs. The Geographic Society of the University of the Philippines, meantime, says Antiporda's behavior is unacceptable for a government official. The Student Society urges the Environment Undersecretary to resign from his position and formally retract his statements against the UPMSI. A quote card circulating online claims former Senator Bam Aquino expressed concern over the construction of a subway due to perennial flooding in the metropolis. The supposed quote attributed to Aquino says, "Is the administration not thinking? A subway will be constructed underground. What will happen if it suddenly floods?" This claim is false. Aquino did not say this. Aquino refuted this claim as early as 2019. He posted a response to the claim, labeling it as a fake quote. Rappler also found no reports or recordings that prove he said this. This claim was also fact-checked by Verifiles. It said the quote originated from Balitangan News Philippines, a satirical and fictional page, but the photo has since been reposted multiple times in a non-satirical manner.